Cualquiera que vea los videos de Kevin que están por YouTube o Instagram puede pensar que el tipo está completamente loco. Pero cuando llegas a conocerlo, te das cuenta que sabe muy bien lo que hace. Y por muchos momentos, te olvidas que su vida corre peligro todo el tiempo. Hoy vamos a ver desde muy cerca cómo es ese coqueteo permanente con la muerte. Desde el principio, Kevin nos dijo que estar cerca de los leones comiendo era de lo más peligroso que se podía hacer. De todas formas, comiendo o no, para nosotros era siempre un peligro. Por eso, Kevin nos dio una jaula para que nos movamos adentro de la subreserva. Nos ubicamos entonces enfrente de un árbol lleno de pedazos de carne. Mirá, ahí van las hembras que llegan primero y empiezan a comer.
Naomi.
La que está ahí, medio atontada y sin encontrar lo que tiene enfrente de los ojos, es Naomi.
Naomi.
A ver, con ayuda de Kevin consigue la mejor porción, pero de la nada le caen los dos machos y se quedan con su parte. Kevin vuelve a ayudarla y se juega la mano para darle unas costillas, porque él ya sabe que acercarse a un león comiendo es querer salir lastimado.
That's because the guys are greedy.
Lo más loco es que mientras tanto, bien tranquilo, el macho alfa estaba ahí, solito, en la sombra, comiéndose las mejores partes.
What you, Kevin Richardson, the lion whisperer, what's the thing you can't do with these animals?
Well, the thing I can't do is go up to Siam now and take his piece of meat away from him. So a lot of people think, oh, you got a great relationship with these lions and can't you just go up there and eat from the same piece of meat as Siam? Now you've just witnessed what he does to get his piece of meat. He stops at nothing. And he dishes out a couple of hard blows to those females to get that meat. What's that going to do to a human being with such delicate flesh? It's going to put me in hospital, if not kill me.
La tenemos atrás vigilándonos hace rato. Pero no molesta, está como relajada. De todos modos no deja de dar miedo así todo.
As the years have gone by, obviously the level of danger has gone down, and that's due to the fact that I know the individual lions and I know the behavior of lions better than I did, say, over 16 years ago. The first time you have enough confidence to do this. It's the first time that you actually think to yourself, okay, it's okay to sit on the ground at a lion's level and let the lion come and flop on top of you. Your instinct is normally to go, okay, that's a lion. The first time I did that, it's going to get your arm in its mouth and it's going to clamp down and it's going to not let you go. So those are all the first. Well, you know, you could know a lion as well as I know Ishka. And when you're sitting on the ground in your most vulnerable position, okay, and a lion's coming towards you, your human instinct, okay, is to get up and be in a position where if something should happen, you could fight her off.
Right.
But here being on my backside, in a position whereby if she just wanted to jump on top of you, she could, and you're completely vulnerable. There's nothing you could do. But it's the breaking that barrier and understanding that trust between this lion and me. It's not just a lion, it's Ishka. I know her intimately, I know what she does, I know her likes, I know her dislikes.
Acercarse a un león mientras come puede ser mortal. Y está claro que esa regla no solo corre para Kevin.
That would happen to you.
That would happen to me if I got to within a position where he felt I was threatening his food. You'd do the same. Now, if you look at her, she's got no blood. It's all just showmanship. But even for me, if he hits me hard enough, his claws are going to come out. If he bites me just gently, he's going to puncture and penetrate my skin. Her skin is very thick and her fur is very coarse. So it's not wise to do what she's doing, but she's doing it because she wants his food.
She wants meat.
Yeah, I don't want his food that badly. So they'll all kind of come until such time as he gives up a piece.
Oh my God.
Yeah, Nobi. Oh. Hello, sweetie. You see, so that's the typical lion to lion head rub that I was talking about. And that's affection.
And they feel jealous between them?
No, there's no jealousy. It's just, it's within a pride, females within a pride. And that's what they do. I often say to people, it takes a lot of courage, but if you can interact with an animal with your hands tied behind your back, that's
the way to do it?
Well, it's a true test, because I don't need to push them away. I'm using my head and my face to interact with their head and their face. Come, Ishki. Oh. Oh. Forget about that nasty, nasty, nasty boy. He's a horrible cat.
Oh, da pada. Oh, da pada, 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 pada. Oh, this is a horrible thing.
Oh, he doesn't want to give you his food.
And your tummy is hungry. Hey? Hey, my sweetheart.
She came back for her cutaways.
Yeah, she wants her too. For how long have you been with her?
Ishka, I've known 9 years.
Nine.
She's one of the lionesses that when I met her, not met her when she was young, but when she was older and she had cubs, she allowed me to be with her cubs. So listen, if I keep him occupied, you run in and get the food, okay? So I'll distract him and you go and get the food. How's that? Is that a deal? You want to shake on it? Yeah? Look at him, he's a pig. He's taken 2 pieces of meat. Eh? Sure.
How heavy is she? The weight?
She's about 160.
That's pounds or kilos?
Kilos.
Oh, there's a male there.
Yeah, so he'll get super agitated with him being there because he knows he can take his food. His tolerance of him in the zone is much less. Even less than me. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, yeah. Hello, my boy. Hello, my boy. Hello, big boy. Hello, big boy. I love you, boy. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, have you finished eating now? Very different. Very different to that cat that was. Hey, not me, man. Stop. So I'll just be submissive. He's like confused because he's still angry. He's still very aggressive because he wants the food. But he wants to come say hello as well. So that's why he does that.
So what's the thing you're doing right there?
I'm just being submissive to him. So he doesn't see me as a threat. which he doesn't. Now he's calmed down.
Yeah.
But he wants to come say hello to me, but at the same token, he wants that food. So he's confused as to how to react to me.
Mixed emotions.
Mixed emotions.
Heavy el momento cuando casi le morfan la carucha a Kevin. Muchachos, subo tensión.
That was... Hey, not me, man. Nothing about I'm going to attack you. He's just showing you that he doesn't want you to be within his presence.
Oh.
So he's saying, okay, leave me alone.
Más allá de lo tranquilo y obediente que se lo pueda ver a Kevin ahí en el piso, fue mucho agite por un día. Y mañana nos espera una parada todavía más brava. Conocer a los bichos con peor prensa del mundo. Las hienas. Pero claro, eso es otra historia.